But yeah, there's some similarities, but there's a lot of differences.
In your own opinion, what would you say the storyline of the show is?
I just think it's three worlds coming together unintentionally. If they start out meaning to be in their own situation, and then fates have it that they have to intermingle, and what happens when that happens, and how chaotic it can be, because everyone's trying to appear that they're okay in their own situation. And I think that's kind of what happens in our world even now. So I think that it's about acceptance and tolerance and love, you know, what drives people when they love someone, what they will do, you know, and it doesn't matter what color you are. If you love someone, you might step out of what you normally would do for love, you know, and about making decisions and choices like younger brother has to make and mother has to make and co-house has to make and dreams. It's a dreaming show. You can, when you sit there, it's, and the show plays like a dream almost, but, and I think sometimes we lose that, the innocence of dreams. We don't think that they're possible anymore. And a lot of what Coalhouse goes through is dreaming of this better life and better time that he feels he's rightly deserved to have, you know? And then he finds out that the world is not really accepting of all his dreams, you know, at the time, so.
I know you said that you really wanted to be in the show and that you really wanted to play this part. Is there like a specific reason why?
I think main reason was a challenge. I've seen Ragtime three times. So I thought that's a challenge. It's not, that wouldn't be easy, you know? So that kind of appealed to me. And the music is so beautiful, you know? And, as a singer, I thought that I'd love to. I'm more of a tenor, baritone tenor. So this is, he's more of a baritone. It is a wide, wide range. So even in that, it's really, really been a challenge to find that voice, you know? And it's just a beautiful story. I remember seeing it and going, it was the best thing that I'd ever seen at the time. And probably still, you know, one of the best musicals that I've ever seen. So there's only been a few parts that I've really, really thought that I wanted to do. And so I'm fortunate.
What's your favorite song in Ragtime?
We can never go back to before Mother sings that song.
Why?
I think, I don't know how many minutes it is, but in that one song, there's so many different layers.
3 minutes and 49 seconds.
Thank you. You're wow. There's so many layers to that, and there's so many layers to Mother's character, and I just thought, what a beautiful voice and well-written song and sentiment. You know what I mean? I think sometimes we're stuck in our past and we don't move forward because we're afraid or whatever. But you can never get before. You can't go back, you know. And she's making a decision not to do that, you know, for her life. And in that time, you know, a woman was subservient to men and, you know, didn't have rights and all, you know. And it was very difficult. We talk about the love issue. You know, does she love her husband? She loves her family. She's doing her duty. But there's a part of her that wants more, you know, and you can just feel that heartbreak in that song and hope in the same thing. I love complex musicals like that, with that they're saying one thing and they have so many underlining, you know, layers.
If you want to call in to ask Terron a question, the number is
970-351-1256. Are you going to play that song?
There was a time our happiness seemed never ending. I was so sure that where we were heading was right. Life was a road so certain and straight and unbending. Our little road with never a crossroad in sight. Back in the days when we spoke in civilized voices, women in white and sturdy young men at the oar. Back in the days when I let you make all my choices. my feet were so solidly planted. You'd sail away while I turned my back to the sea. I was content, a princess asleep and enchanted. If I had dreams, then I let you dream them for me. Back in the days when everything seemed so much clearer, women in white who knew what their lives held in store. Where are they now, those women who stared from the mirror? We can never go back to before. People out there, unafraid of revealing that they might have a feeling, or they might have been wrong. There are people out there, unafraid to feel sorrow, unafraid of tomorrow, unafraid to be weak, unafraid to be strong.
What is happening in Lawrence is happening everywhere. Let us at last make this the land of opportunity for all people, not just the owners. The land of opportunity for Tata and this little girl. We cannot rest!
She was speaking loud and fast through a haze of noise and heat, and the smell of sweat and anger in the air. The police were standing by, but the crowd was on its feet. The night that Goldman spoke at Union Square.
You!
He thought he heard her say,
what brings you here today?
Poor young rich boy.
Masturbates for a vaudeville tart. What a waste of a fiery heart, dear.
Poor young bourgeois.
There are things that you've never thought. Come to Emma and you'll be taught here.
His head was spinning.
People feathered and taught, my friend. Unions broken and why for? Children laboring, women still enslaved. Leave your little backyard, my friend. There are causes to die for. Strike
the gutters of the city. I am trying to find some meaning.
Strike
the arms of fallen women in the thought of suicide.
Show you how, my brother, you are with us now.
He was calling out her name, shouting what he did not know, and he found that he was standing on a chair with a heart as clean and new as the freshly fallen snow. The night that Goldman spoke,
I've been waiting for you.
At Union Square.
You're back with Blondie.
And Ginger.
And we're here with our special guest from Broadway.
They don't want to say my name ever. I have to say it. Terron Brooks. Hi, guys.
So, Terron, you also do music and songwriting.
Yes, I do.
Can you tell us a little bit about that?
I've been doing that for a long, long time. That's actually my first love. My passion is to write songs and be a singer-songwriter artist. And then I kind of fell into musical theater and did some films. But I love, it's my own expression, you know, when you're saying someone else's words and mm-hmm. acting someone else's, that's great. But when you can really express yourself. So I've been doing it for a while. I have about 5 records out. I'm my 6th record I'm halfway done with, and it'll be coming out in May. And this is my dream project. This I did this thing called Kickstarter. I don't know if anybody who's listening know, you go and you can get money, people can pledge money for your project. It's amazing. So I raised over $9,000.
Wow.
For my project, and I don't owe anybody back, but they get rewards, like mm-hmm. maybe a phone call or a signed CD, or they'll get the CD before someone else, everyone gets it, or private concert or something like that. But it's a cool thing. Kickstarter.com, whatever project you have, you can get funding. You set a goal and you set an amount of time. So my goal was $7,000 in 45 days. And just people from high school, old teachers, family members. It's incredible. Pledge. And then on Valentine's Day was the last day, and I raised like over $9,000. You don't get the money unless you get the goal. So it's kind of, it's cool for the people that are investing, so you're not taking money and then there's no project. So mm-hmm. So yeah, I've been working on that. So I love that.
Who's your musical inspiration?
Oh, wow, I have so many. For different reasons. Probably I would say Babyface for writing, because he wrote for so many different artists. And I love Michael Jackson, Stevie Wonder. God, the list goes on. But, yeah, I like a lot of different people.
What is your favorite new song?
On the radio?
No, that you wrote.
Oh, my favorite new song. I would say my new single is called Moment in Your Life. And I just love the song because people are really responding to it, because it's written, it's kind of a negative song talking about problems and stuff in your life. And then, but it's basically just saying it's just a moment. Like sometimes we focus on the bad things in our life and we make them bigger than all the great things that are happening in our lives. And so I just wrote a song saying, wow, in the scheme of your whole life, your bad time or your hard time or your breakup or your whatever you're going through is just a moment in relation to everything else. And so people are really responding to it. So I think it's probably the best. It's the rawest song I have vocally.
Well, let's play that song.
Yay.